Welcome to ThreatLive Stadium here in New York, home of the Tyrants. Boy, they really cleaned up Times Square, huh? I kind of miss the sea of wandering zombies and the stench of the open zombie landfills. And they had this nice all-you-could-shoot zombies in a barrel arcade, I remember.
Yeah, those are the good old days, Grim.
Now it's just a tourist attraction. Peep shows and organized crime. Today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams take the field. The Hexxon Oilers take on the New Yuck Tyrants. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Welcome to MFL Sunday School, where the good playbook teaches it's an eye for no reason, a tooth for an eight ball, and a limb for just looking at me the wrong way. MFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow, my partner's Bricks and Bricks Jr. Hey, man, these guys flat out want to kill each other today.
Yeah, these are the kind of games families come out to see. It's good for the sport.
You know, what I like about this home team is 90% of them were born criminally insane. You can't teach that. The quarterback passes the ball and it rebounds back.
He can't get rid of it. It's like me and these crabs, Grim.
Yep, the defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick and the QB is in a heap of trouble now. Second down and more than the QB would like. Unstoppable force meets the explodable object. And it's first and 10. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and 10. Roid Rage, how do you like your brains? Scrambled or fried? One Roid Rage breakfast special coming up, and he's off to the races. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die! And, that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And it's first and 10. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And that'll be second and 8 to go. It was a risky throw and the defense made him pay. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Sounds like my off-season.
And it's first and 10. Oh, with the punishing hit. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey,
Sorry, partner. Oh, nice hit! And it's first and ten. Somehow and hold on for the first down.
A man from prison just came out of the field.
It's the ref, idiot.
Oh.
Let's see what the penalty is. First down and three. Is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. He picks up a two. And that'll bring up second and one. And the defense spiked the offensive water with strawberry fields. And now they can taste sound, but can't remember what the concept of time is.
Sounds like you every day.
Third and four. It's not short, but this one shouldn't give the kicker any trouble.
Unless he collapses under pressure and never makes another kick again.
That's bleak, Bricks. Well, surprise me, he made it look easy and he gets 3 points for it. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Oh, with the brutal hit! First and ten, and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not gonna take it anymore. First down in a mile. Pick six, but drop the interception.
And it plays on defense, schmuck.
Second down, and ain't gonna happen, partner. Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he put all of his foot into that one. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grin. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth!
And that's how you run it, folks. Picks up. Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome! I hope they had raincoats in the front row, because that was splattering everywhere!
Second down and two.
Hot one, hot two.
And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
Yeah.
third and two. Comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. And he's got a chance for a good return here. Oh, what a brutal hit! And it's first and ten. Says, I don't think so. Second down and 10. I'm going to say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. And that'll bring up third down and 7. That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game. And it's first and 10. He runs it for 3. Second down and 7. Just keep pounding the ball right up the gut and you'll tire these guys out. First down. And it's first and 10. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
No, still working on my salami here, Bricks. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep.
Second down and 7. No, oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a console wasn't home.
Third down and 5. I just made the commentary, but I thought you were supposed to throw the ball forward.
Yeah, you're right. You should.
They get ready for the kick. This isn't a gimme. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuff burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down and forever.
Hot one, hot two.
I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but can we get him some? Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. It's first and 10. And that's another pick. Man, oh man, the defense is going to have pow. And how about a little Dirk sandwich? Second down and a lot.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
Oh, mama, he just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Says, I'm taking you with me. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. The offense is running low on running backs. They have only two left. Need to conserve those runners now and consider passing more. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Briggs.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
It's first and 10. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick. Second down and 10. A gain of 7 yards on the catch. Nicely done. Third down and 3. Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
Excuses for this QB.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And it's first and 10.
You know, this berserk 30 kicking stands in a QB.
Boom, and he's dead. The offense offense lost another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Yeah, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
And it's first and 10. And the runner is moving crazy fast. 4 yards on that one. And he was just starting to pick up some speed. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Well, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Briggs? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort. And he just got so mad and cursed anyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but yeah, not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
Third down and 6. He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? The offense lost their last running back on the previous play. Next time the offense comes out in the field, they will have no running plays. And it's first and 10. That ball just sliced through the defense like butter.
I wish defenses were...
Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
A smart move there, stopping the clock with their first time out.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
And it's first and 10. And this guy looks like Thor on a revenge bender right now.
First down! I've seen this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a...
They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
And it's first and 10. Oh, that's a vicious hit. Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
Second and 3. And that'll give him 4 more downs to punish the defense. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. If you don't think you can make the interception, batting it down is the next best thing.
Great advice, Grim. That receiver's gonna go far in this league if he listens to you.
I wasn't talking to... never mind. Yes, Brick, he will. And there's another pick. Man, this... Oh, nice hit! First and 10. And that's another turnover for the defense. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Briggs. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. And the defense gets another pick. Man, oh, what a hit. Hey, Briggs, what does it feel like to get hit like that?
Like being dropped off a 10-story building with a refrigerator strapped to your back and landing on a fire hydrant.
Yeah, great analogy.
Oh, no, that really happened. COD game got a little out of hand last night.
You can't have 5 aces, you dumbass.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
It's a close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsatan Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. It's anyone's game as the third quarter begins. Both teams have taken their performance-enhancing drugs, and everyone is ready to rock and roll. The teams line up for the second half kickoff. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Briggs. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. And it's first and ten. And that'll be a first down. You know, Bricks, a lot of people have gotten pass happy in this league. Nice to see some old school mano a mano on the turf, huh? The New Yuck Tyrants bash the opposition into nothingness and walk away with a win by forfeit. There's not much left of the opposition, and the fans are loving it. There was only one way this game was going to end, and that was in a forfeit.
That's not quite true, Grim. An alien spacecraft could have crashed into the stadium and ended the game. How about it?
How about if you shut the hell up right now? We go down to the field and listen to what the MVP has to say. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Microhard Corporation. They get it right every other...